It's extremely exciting. I'm very much looking forward to this opportunity of representing the ward residents of East Brighton. I have the passion, the desire to make sure East Brighton is one of the best wards in the city. I also believe that I would be the only Lib Dem councillor in the ward. I would not have a leader to follow. I'll be able to talk to residents personally and I'll be able to find out what they want me to do. I offer a new vision. There is no Lib Dems sitting councillors. I believe I offer this brand new way. The Tories and Greens will say they will offer something different, but they're on the council right now and they've not made any changes. Labour will say they're doing really well, but of course they haven't. When I've been knocking on doors talking to people, they are saying that there are things horribly wrong, and I believe the Lib Dems are the ones to definitely make this ward a much better place, and I believe I'm the right person for this.
So in the upcoming by-election, the Lib Dems will have a party policy strongly focused on housing in East Brighton.
Well, of course, we've got housing. That is a very big part. Like I did say with the housing petition, that is something we know it's all around the city, so we will push it. We also spoke, when we spoke to people, homelessness came up, so we want to find a good way to make sure more shelters are open all year round around the city. And also Madeira Terrace, a lot of people are still worried about that. Of course, the funding has ended, but apparently it's not going to be started working until a bit later. But then we'll also find out other policies as we talk to other people, and we will push more, we'll find more agendas to put out there, of course, with topics like Brexit still dominating the local scene.
George will be running up against Nancy Platt, who was announced as the Labour candidate last night. So what does he think of his biggest competitor?
Oh, she's going to be very tough, of course. She did put the Simon Kirby's majority to 690, I believe, in the 2015 election, but I'm 100% up for the fight. I look forward to having many battles with her.
It has been a little while since the Lib Dems were in power in Brighton and Hove City Council. So if elected, why would George be the right man for the job?
East Brighton has been dominated by Labour, and Labour have gone with one image and they will take your vote for granted. They will believe you're going to vote for them no matter what, but they're going to keep with the same things they've been going year in, year out, and Whitehawk and the whole ward is going to be still the same. The Greens and the Tories will have their own different ways, but they're in the council at the moment and have not changed a thing. I believe only I am the one who can change it, and I do hope you vote for me on the by-election.